Hey guys, so my last video I made was about how to unban 002-0102. So in that video, I explained how to unban if you have a second 3DS. I said a couple sentences about how to unban if you only have one, but people still had questions. So in this video, I'm going to be emphasizing how to unban with only one console. This is a lot easier, and I'll be completely remaking the video too, so I won't reuse any old footage from previous videos. So let me explain a little bit about the process of unbanning. All you have to do to unban is inject a local friend code seed B, which is a file inside of the 3DS's NAND, if you didn't know, from an unbanned console into a banned one. So there is multiple ways to get one of these files. You can either use a public one or get one from someone who trusts you, like a friend. So the positives to using a public one is that it's easy to access. The downfall is that a lot of people are going to be using it, so it's more likely to get banned. On the other hand, if you got one from a friend, it won't get banned as long as everyone using it is responsible, meaning turn off spot pass and don't do anything stupid to get banned again. There's no limit to the amount of people who can use a local friend code seed B, but keep in mind that if you're planning to give your consoles to a friend, you should trust them, because if one of you gets banned, all of you using that local friend seed will be banned. So let's get into it. I just told you how to obtain one of these files, so you should start by getting one of them. I have a public one in the description. Again, it isn't guaranteed to work, but it should at the time of making this video. So keep that file handy because we'll need it in a minute. On your 3DS, open up System Settings, and then tap on Internet Settings. Then tap on Spot Pass, and then Sending of System Information. You want to click No to disable this. This will stop Nintendo from seeing which titles you open and stuff, so you won't get banned again. You can also click No on automatic software downloads so Nintendo doesn't send you stuff over Spot Pass. So once that's done, you want to turn off your console and then put the SD card inside of your PC. We're going to copy the local friend code seed B onto it. Most of you should have a folder called Files 9 on the SD card. If you don't, you can just create one. We're going to paste the local friend code seed B inside of that. Now make sure you have Decrypt 9 because we'll be using that to inject the file. Again, most of you should have it because this is used in almost all guides on how to install any kind of mods, and you need to have modded your console in some way to even get banned. So once all that's done, eject the SD card and then put it back inside of your console. I'll meet you on there. Now you want to load into Decrypt 9 however you usually do. You should see a menu like this. So you should go into System NAND or EmuNAND options depending on which one you want to unban. If you use Gateway, it'll most likely be EmuNAND, and if you use Luma or something, it'll most likely be System NAND. I'll unban my EmuNAND. So go into the options menu for whichever one, and then go to System File Dump, and then dump local friend code seed B. Make sure you change the name because we already have a file with this name. So I'm just going to change mine to MU local friend code seed B. So press A to dump the file. This is just a backup in case we need it, in case anything else fails. Now go back twice and click System File Inject, and then inject local friend code seed B. It'll ask you to enter a key combination. So press the combination and then choose the file local friend code seed B. Press A to inject the file. When it's done, you should be unbanned. You can power off your 3DS and check to see if you got unbanned. So yeah, that's it. Thanks for watching, leave a like if this video helped you, comment if you need help or if you want to help anyone else, and subscribe for more videos like this in the future, and I'll see you next time.